well as a film that we received a grant from the Theatre of Hollywood. Thank you, everybody who is members and contributed your dues to the Theatre of Hollywood. We got support from the Theatre of Hollywood and a sizable contribution from the National Film Preservation Foundation, which you'd be happy to know, they get their money from Congress. So the United States actually paid for the preservation of Hangover. This is a film made in 1964. This is the fourth screening of it that I'll have done, where you'll be able to see the film in a newly restored state. It took 7 years, and I finally, at the very last minute, after doing a 4K transfer from an interpositive, managed to find the camera original negative. And we remastered from that. And then, together with eFilm, did a very fastidious restoration to it. There really wasn't much done to it. It was just dirt and dust and stuff and stuff like that. There were no scratches. There was no harm that came to the film. I think that was pretty much all they did was make the IP, and that was all they made. And they made prints off of that. And they made intermediates off of that. For those of you who know about film, have you ever heard of film? So anyway, it's soon going out. It's going to 35mm, and a copy will be stored at the Academy Film Archive, and another copy will be stored at the Library of Congress. So if you know the film festival and want to borrow it, you would approach either of those two organizations to have funding rights to borrow it for your festival. The other 14 films we're very fortunate to have a really interesting array of films. We have films that was directed by Glenn Keane. Glenn Keane's newest film, Dear Basketball. This was funded by a celebrity basketball player named Kobe Bryant. This is his personal ode to basketball, all that it brought to his life, the empowerment. He felt that particular edition of the show shows, even though it is chronologically organized, it's stuff that's fairly new with a couple of old films. It's about humanity. It's about finding our place in the world. It's about respecting other people. And it's hopefully it'll leave you with an optimistic note. Because the last film is a film by David O'Reilly. His film is online. You probably can find it very easily. It's called Everything. Has anybody seen it? So it's mattering of you. Who are professionals. The two of you should have seen it. So, of course, you saw it. Jeanette Bonds, who I will attribute a great appreciation for programming the first film in the Tonight Show, to do it, which is a film by a French group. And it's actually our first music video in 19 years. And you programmed that last year at Glass Animation. And the year before, for those of you who saw the 18th animation, we can really thank, without a question, we can thank Jeanette for the fact that we had a STEM show by Ainsley Hensley. Fantastic film. You remember that film? I mean, that 2.5 minutes of absolutely stunning cinema, and if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have had that. Thank you, Jeanette.
Okay.
I genuinely appreciate it. Anyway, I apologize for talking so long. You're the only group who actually made all the way to talk. My family won't. Anyway, it's an eclectic mix, and I'm very excited about having everything conclude the show. How many of you have heard of Only One? Read it? You're far more literate. I was unfamiliar with this work until I saw this and fell in love with this. And so I really encourage you to stick around and experience. And of course, we're very fortunate to have the AMSI Grand Prix winner called The Birdie. And it's a pretty important film, I think. That film stuff. So I'm not going to talk about all of the films, but there is kind of this narrative that goes on in the show. There are three films in which people are actually expressing their voices. And I think it's really important as an underlying theme within the show. And it's about humanity and But we actually today have one filmmaker with us, Elise DeMars. Elise is right over here. She's the director of one of the films from Canada. I promise you, I would not forget your first. I would not forget your name, but I forgot your first title.
Beautiful.
What's that?
Beautiful.
Elsewhere. A gorgeous film. Last year we put a non-narrative film in from Norway. Those of you who saw it, we did a little documentary. Unfortunately, this year, because we had some financial challenges with Kickstarter, we didn't have enough money to produce a documentary. We do hope still to produce some, but we'll see how that goes. I think four of the films are shortlisted are qualified for Oscar consideration because they have really strong shots. But I think it empowered me showing the film Boygan to include more non-narrative, less obvious narrative filmmaking. So today we'll see this lovely film. And she's come all the way from French Canada to Montreal to talk about it and to answer any of your questions. So without further ado, I appreciate your patience. Let's enjoy the